Hi, everybody. My name is Tori Swanson, and I'm going to share my journey with you so you know a little bit about where I am, who I am, and where I came from. So as an artist, I was always a very artistic child, and I always did a lot of artwork all the time. When it came time to go to university, I had actually taken a lot of courses correspondently, so online, so that I could take more art courses in school and high school. I had really great grades, but for some reason, and now I know with universal law, I didn't get into any of the schools I wanted to get into except for the art schools. And I judged that a lot. So much so that I went reluctantly to a local art college because I just wasn't sure what I wanted to do with my life. And it all felt like there was a lot happening when you're 18 years old and trying to make these decisions. I was 17 at the time, so I was really not knowing what it was I really wanted to do with my life. And so I actually loved going to art school, but I really judged it. I didn't know what I would get with a BFA, and I was constantly looking at the end outcome instead of what it felt like to go to school. So I spent a lot of time traveling in my summers. I dropped out of art school. I went to academic school and studied communications, and I spent my summers in Southeast Asia, in Europe, just saving all the money I could so that I could escape. When I went to Southeast Asia, I came home that summer because I went over the spring, April to July, and I had lost about 15 pounds. And during that time, I developed an eating disorder called anorexia and bulimia. And I actually got accepted into fashion school days when I came home because I applied to FIT in New York City while I was away. And I was waitlisted, but I got confirmation the moment I came home. And so I decided I was gonna go. I took out a loan, I figured it out. My parents helped pay for my flight. I was 20 years old at the time. And I went to fashion school in New York City. And I was living my dream at the time. I thought I wanted to work in fashion. And everything sort of just happened. I had such crazy experiences of just being at the right moment at the right time, dating celebrities, being in the know-how in New York City. What looked like a fairy tale was really sadness, and I got really, really thin. I was really depressed, and I came home that Christmas break, and I didn't go back. I went into therapy instead. I was a mess. I had so much anxiety and depression that had been accruing over time since high school. And I didn't know, I didn't have a healthy way of working through it. I just didn't know. I thought you just pushed it down. I just woke up one day and I felt different. And there was no sort of explanation at the time. This would have been 2010 to 2012, where mental health wasn't really something that we knew much about. In fact, I thought anxiety was like a made-up thing until the therapist told me it actually wasn't, which we all know today that anxiety is very much alive and well. And so I started getting help, and my whole plan was to go back to New York at the end of January when classes recommenced. But as it was very clear how sick I was, I couldn't go back. I wanted to be home. I wanted to just be in my bed all the time. I was working for Lululemon Athletica at the time during that Christmas break, and they offered me a role to stay on and actually move into a supervisor role where I was then leading teams and such. Working for Lululemon was one of the most amazing experiences in my life because they really helped me take responsibility for my life. They sent me to a lot of self-help programs and were really supportive of my mental health at the time. And I actually met one of my best friends there who supported me with my artwork. She said she came home over to my house one day and she noticed I had stacks and stacks and stacks of like canvases under my bed. And I was like, okay, we're just gonna quickly get changed and get leave out of the house. But then while I was changing, she pulled out some of my artwork and she said, what the hell is this? And I said, I paint for fun. It's something that I do in my downtime. And I started to reconnect with my painting as a form of therapy. It was like the only thing that really helped me move through this anxiety because the artwork didn't judge me. It was just a raw canvas where I could express myself where words couldn't quite depict how I felt. And so I was able to mix paints and get creative and use my full body that was so tense for so long. And I'd honestly find myself falling asleep after I painted because I released so much energy that I was able to relax, for the first time in years. And she encouraged me to have my first art show. And I had my first art show and it was a wild success. I was like so nervous, but I sold a lot of artwork. And given I was pricing it at a really fair cost at the time, but I have a photo of me with my first check for my piece of artwork, and it was one of the most thrilling experiences of my life. It was also the first time I had a message delivered for me from Universal Intelligence. A woman showed up at the store, because I was hosting it at the Lululemon store, and she said, "I don't know why I'm here. All I know is that I felt like I needed to come to the certain mall in West Vancouver." She lived in Langley. She went to Whole Foods and she saw a flyer that I had printed out and put on a bulletin board, and she knew that's where she needed to be. She showed up, knocked on the store door and said, "I don't know what the hell I'm doing in here, but I love your artwork." And at the time I was playing with nude figure drawings. And she said, "You need to focus on those nude drawings because that's going to shape your career." And then she left. So I had my first experience with spirit in that moment. I didn't quite fully understand it, but I was on cloud nine and I knew that that was what I needed to do with my life. So flash forward years later, I was hosting my own art shows in the city, in Vancouver, wherever I could. I was renting out spaces. I was getting sponsored by local companies that wanted to have me and my artwork because they love my message of spreading positive body awareness into the community, because art really did heal me from my body image. And ever since that show, women came up to me to ask for their own portraits. And I was doing these nude sketches at the time. And I'll show you those in a later video. And so I started doing nude sketches for women who would come to me, sit down, take their clothes off, and have me draw their bodies. And at the time, I was so awkward with it. But the more and more comfortable I got with it, the more I saw how I could be of service with my artwork. And it was in one of those times where I eventually started to open up a little bit more spiritually. And while I was doing so, I was working at a tech company called Hootsuite. It was like the main days. It was doing so well. People were basically throwing money at the company. It was a really fun place to work. And I left Lululemon to work in tech so I could learn how to market myself and understand the digital world, social selling, so that I could apply that to my own business and be a success. And during that time, I never lost touch with my artwork, but my priorities shifted. And it was during that time where I started to also seep back into depression. The more disconnected I became from my artwork, the more my old habits came up, like my body image dysmorphia or spending money frivolously because of my lack of self-acceptance. And it came time that I was like, I can't live like this anymore. So I got a coach. It wasn't that easy, but to give you like the high summary of my life, how I got here, I started working with an intuitive coach. Her name's Lynette Brown. She's amazing. Her website is consciousstrategies.com. And she taught me everything I knew how to coach. And so I started coaching. And I started coaching other women who wanted to own their creative services. But we'll get to that in a minute. I started having these psychic experiences where I was like seeing things at night. I was knowing things about people before I had met them. I knew things were gonna happen before they did. And as a child, I had experiences like this, but it wasn't really fostered, nor was it something that we knew much of. So it kind of got shut off, but it reopened. And so I started working with this coach to help me develop my senses, to help me implement this into my daily life, because I was always into the paranormal. And I started implementing that with my intuitive nude portraits. I started sitting down with these women, doing a reading with them, intuitively connecting on a very deep soul level, moving any energy blocks in their lives so that we'd get into the portrait situation. And then all of a sudden we've had this beautiful experience where I've seen women move from being shy and insular to being like fully expressed and confident in their bodies with this artwork that they get to hang on their wall as an emblem of this experience so they can remember who they really are. And this gave me so much power to continue doing this work. I was doing this for a while until I finally was like, screw it, I'm doing this full time and I'm quitting my job. I had some money saved up. I had recently gone back to New York on a business trip where I was selling the Hootsuite product to some companies, and I was like there for 2 weeks and I was like, God, the next time I am here, I am not gonna be here for somebody else. I'm gonna be here for me. And so I literally got home, I quit my job, I gave in my notice. I had like $10,000 saved up from my commission checks, which was a lot, but not enough. And I also decided to go traveling around the world with my partner at the time. So I blew all my money in like a few months, which really had me working hard to stay afloat. And I worked part-time jobs. I started developing my intuition. I started working and doing psychic readings and coaching, and eventually my business built. But it took time, and it took a mindset shift. It took having unwavering faith. It took knowing that I wanted to be an artist and my goal in life is to be in the Louvre before I die, to see my artwork, to see it inspire others and shift people's lives, to help other people become profitable creators, to help other people be rich and follow their passion, because the world would be a completely different place if we were able to do so and have that faith in ourselves. And so I'm not telling you I'm perfect. I still struggle. There are days where we have great days and low days, but all of that gets channeled into my artwork as inspiration. We have to be resilient as artists. We have to be willing to shift and work on a dime. And we also have to be authentically ourselves. Don't listen to the bullshit of critics and people who are not in your corner. Do not listen to people who are giving you unsolicited advice, because the only person whose advice really matters in this world is your own. That's it. And I cannot wait to help foster this with you and help you grow your self-trust and your self-acceptance, that you can be this flourishing, wealthy artist you are meant to be. And so the last few years of my business, I've been doing this for 4 years now, have been a wild ride. I grew my business to a six-figure business within the first 2 years. And ever since then, it's been growing steadily since I bought my first home in Squamish, BC, Canada, and a very budding real estate market. And I'm really proud. And there's so much more we want to do in this world. So the more that we can let go of our expectations and step back into our intent as an artist and come back to why we paint in the first place, or take photos or draw or do pottery, will help you become more successful, because that is your why. And my why has always been to heal. It has always been to bring in pleasure and joy in my life and to communicate where I can't quite find the words to do so. And it still makes me pass out after I paint to this day, because it truly does heal your body. So I look forward to working with you guys. I look forward to sharing all my insight with you and learning more about you. If there's any topics you want to cover, put them in the comment box below. Hit the subscribe button so that we can stay in touch and that you don't miss a beat, because I want to share everything I know with you. And I hope that you too will become successful as you are meant to be. All right, lots of love, and we'll see you later. Bye.